CST element in finite elements method. For the point P located inside the triangular element as shown in the figure. So, the point P is located at the center of the triangular element. And if the shape functions n1, n2 are 0.3 and 0.5 respectively, find its x and y coordinates and left out the shape functions. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे पॉइंट पी पे आपको दो कोऑर्डिनेट रहेगा, दो ग्लोबल कोऑर्डिनेट, वो है एक्स और वाई रहेगा. ठीक है, और शेप फंक्शंस दिया है n1 और n2 दिया है. ठीक है, आपको n3 कैलकुलेट करना है. इट मींस यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द एक्स वैल्यू एंड वाई वैल्यू, एंड आल्सो यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट द लेफ्ट आउट शेप फंक्शंस मीन्स n1, n2, अनदर लेफ्ट आउट विल बी n3, you have to calculate, right? So, as I said you in the previous class, there are two methods to solve the CST elements. One, using the isoparametric representation or isoparametric expression, and second one, we can calculate by using the shape function expression. Okay, so as in the previous classes, we have solved using the shape function expression. So now we will try by using the isoparametric representation or expression using the isoparametric expression method the coordinates of coordinates of point P that is x and y can be written as. Okay, so for the isoparametric expression where x is equal to x1 minus x3 into n1 plus x2 minus x3 into n2 plus x3. Okay, where y I will tell you. First let me calculate the x coordinate. So here we need to substitute the x1 x3. So as all of you know, these are the local coordinate system. Here it will be x1 y1 at node 1, at node 2 x2 y2, at node 3 x3 y3, and at the point P x and y, and now at the point P the x value is we are going to be calculating. Okay, so now you substitute the value of x1 that is 2, next x3 that is 3 into shape functions. N1 is given in the quotient, that is 0.3, so 0.3 plus x2 is 4 minus x3 is 3 into n2 is 0.5 plus x3 that is 3. Okay, so from this calculation, so minus 1 into 0.3 plus 0.5 plus 3, so 3.2 we will obtain from the calculation. So this is the x value. Similarly, we will calculate for y value, where y is equal to same y1 minus y3 into n1 plus, instead of x we have to write y2 minus y3 n2 plus y3. Okay, so now again y1 value we have to substitute here. Y1 is 1, y3 is 5 into n1 is again 0.3 plus y2 value that is 2 and y3 is 5 into n2 0.5 plus y3 is 5. Okay, so now 1 minus 5 that is minus 4 into minus 4 into 0.3, so minus 3 into 0.5, so plus 5, so 2.3. So y coordinate is 2.3. okay, so now the point at x is 3.2 comma y is 2.3. so first we have calculated, find the x and y coordinates. This is the answer for the first one. Similarly, we need to calculate the shape functions. What are the left out shape functions? Okay, so we know where sum of all the shape function, that is n1, n2 plus n3 is equal to 1. Okay, now we are having n1 value, that is 0.3. similarly, we are having n2, that is 0.5 plus n3 is equal to 1. So it is 0.8 plus n3 is equal to 1. N3 is equal to 1 minus 0.8, so around you will get 0.2 is the answer. Okay, now if you add all the shape functions like n1 plus n2 plus n3, it should be is equal to 1. Okay, that is n1 value 0.3 plus 0.5, next n3 is 0.2, so it becomes 1. It means the whatever the value calculated, which is right. Okay, so thank you for watching. Please subscribe the channel.